I do want to bring in our headliner right now, Wharton Professor Jeremy Siegel, joining us once again. Professor, it's always good to talk to you. Welcome back.
Hello, Scott.
How are you feeling about the market today? You know, you've put us in the seventh inning stretch the last time you were on, you know, close to a month ago. We had a hotter than expected inflation read. You had yields go higher, and then they reversed themselves. And I've got the S&P at a new high. I've got the NASDAQ at a new high. Tech seems to be rolling in this environment. How do you see it?
Well, you know, Scott, I've been saying for months that inflation is going to be much higher than what the Fed thinks it's going to be. I actually think we're only seeing the tip of the iceberg in terms of the data. And the Fed will have to move. But, you know, they're throwing so much money still at the economy that, you know, it's still going to flow into stocks. We're not over with the bull market by any means. But the Fed is going to be forced to act. Maybe they will announce the taper at the July meeting. Absolutely, in my opinion, no later than the August Jackson Hole meeting. And again, there'll be tremors, but the money is still coming. So, and stocks are real assets, as I pointed out all the time. So it's going to still flow into those real assets. Now, I do think, and I certainly agree with many of the you know, your commentators about quality stocks, tech and otherwise. I do think that the only inflation protected yield, because there's going to be much more inflation, is really the dividend paying stocks. So if you're into that sort of market, they will become attractive later on. You know, treasuries, yeah, 1.5, and inflation's going at 6, 7, 8, 9. Bank accounts, your money is just disappearing. Municipals the same way. You want to go into TIPS, -1% yield. So, you know, if you want that income, I still think that people are going to look around and say that those dividend-paying stocks are where I'm going to go.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean you should avoid tech, but it means that's something you should think about.
Mary Daly was on the network earlier today. She, of course, the San Francisco Fed president, reiterated once again her belief that inflation is transitory. If you look at the bond market and the yield activity, the bond market move, Professor, would suggest that you're wrong, right? I mean, unless the bond market is totally getting it wrong, or if yields are just depressed because of all of the liquidity. But if the market thought that you were right, yields would not be sitting at 135, 136, and having gone from 175 down to that level.
Okay, but remember one thing, that the curve has steepened. Remember, actually, if I'm a long-term bondholder, I want the Fed to move in a way, because if they don't, then just my money is going to depreciate. And so there's sort of a good, bad thing. If this forces them to move early, I still think the yields are going to go up over 2%. But again, we talked about the Delta variant. The treasuries are still the number one hedge short term for investors. They're willing to bite the bullet on inflation, lose value, as long as they have that hedge asset. There are many more things than just inflation that go into the long bond. And I think people are paying the price, and it's going to get even more expensive later on.
Well, you said 2% on the 10-year. Is that by the end of the year we're going above 2%?
I think so, because I think, you know, I was looking at the data, and, 60% of the CPI is housing. According to the BLS, which does the statistics, that is up between 2.5% and 3% from a year ago. Now, you tell me that housing prices and even rentals are up to 2.5% to 3%. It is the antiquated way they put it into the index. That's going to start filtering into the index second half of this year. You know, we may have 8, 9, 10%. It's already in there. They can't do anything about it. But they can stop inflation in 2022. They, you know, stop, do the taper, and begin to start raising the rates. And I think they're going to be forced to go into that direction.
But what do you say to those who would suggest, well, you're being alarmist, Professor? Look at lumber. Look at lumber, right? Lumber's given up.
In what sense?
Well, in terms of this big call about inflation. I would say, okay,
I think there's going to be a big, I think there's going to be a lot more inflation. Is that alarmist? Do you want to hold real assets? Do you want to hold stock? I'm not selling my stocks.
But I mean, if you look at lumber, if lumber's given up all of its gains on the year, and that was one of the I'm sorry?
It's still up at least 50, from my last reading, up 50% from the pre-pandemic level. All those have come down, some of them, although the CRB index and oil are just about at their highs, but they're still 20, 30%, 40% above the levels they were a year ago.